Hi guys, I'm Seema and today we are going to study about simplification. I'll be making many more useful videos on the topics related to quant, reasoning and English for phase 1 of RBI and SEBI. If you like my video, then don't forget to subscribe to our channel and for regular updates, hit the bell icon. Although it's a very simple and scoring topic, a lot of students are not very confident about this because of the involvement of a lot of functions and variables. There are few universal formulas and tricks to make such questions easier. Let us start with few such basics. Bodmer's rule. This rule depicts the correct sequence in which operations are to be executed so as to find out the value of a given expression. Here, first of all, we solve the brackets. And there are three types of brackets, smaller ones, square ones, the curled ones. After solving the brackets, we solve the order, power or indices. This is denoted by O. And thirdly, we solve division, then multiplication, then addition and then subtraction. This is very important. Division, multiplication, addition and then subtraction. And in simplification, a lot of variables and exponents are used. So here are few rules which would help you solving them. Multiplication rule. See, 2 to the power 2 to 2 to the power 4 goes for 2 to the power 6. We just add them. When the variables are in multiplication, we add the powers. Division rule. For division, we subtract the powers. And if power of a power rule, 2 to the power 2 to the power 4, then we multiply the powers. It becomes 2 to the power 8, not 6. In the earlier case, it was 6 when the variables were multiplied. Product rule, 2 into 3 to the power 2 could be written as 2 square multiplied by 3 square. See if they are equal. Yes, they are equal. This is also very simple power of a fraction rule. We can individually give the power to denominator and numerator. Zero exponent. If we say something's power is 0, 2 to the power 0 is 1. Power 0 means it is in its normal state. A negative power, if it is given that 4 to the power minus 2, then we write it as 1 divided by 4 to the power 2. Or simply a to the power minus x is equals to 1 by a to the power x. Fractional exponents. So here we write, for example, 8 to the power 2 by 3 means 8 square and then cube root of 8 square. 4 is the answer. You should memorize all this so as to solve the questions easily and save your time. Question 1. Simplify 0.46 multiplied by 0.46 plus 0.54 multiplied by 0.54 plus 0.92 multiplied by 0.54. Let us say 0.46 is A, 0.54 is B. So from this given equation, you could see that A square, this is A square plus B square plus 0.92 is nothing but 2 multiplied by 0.46. 2 times 0.46 and A, B. You all must be familiar with this formula. This is nothing but A plus B whole square. A is 0.46, B is 0.54 whole square. When we add them, we get 1 square 1. So answer is A. In such questions, you don't actually have to multiply them and then find the result and then add it up. See it intelligently that if you could form some variables and find such equations and simplify it. Question 2. If the sum of two numbers is 22 and the sum of their square is 404, then the product of numbers is, as per the question, let the numbers be A and B. A plus B is equals to 22 and A square plus B square is equals to 404. This is our equation 1 and this is equation 2. You all must be knowing this formula. A plus B whole square is equals to A square plus B square plus 2AB. We will be using this formula to solve the question further. From equation 1, we could see that A plus B is equals to 22 square is equals to A square plus B square. These two terms, you can find them from the equation 2. Their value is 404 plus 2AB. Here, we are doing nothing but just putting the value from equation 1 and 2 into this format. So, the square of 22 is 484 is equals to 404 plus 2AB. 2AB is 80. AB is equals to 40. So, the product of the two numbers is 40. Question 3. Under root x percent of under root 1849 into 20 plus 22.7 is equals to 2602.7. So first of all, we will find the square root of 1489. The number can have either 3 or 7 at the units place. And as we know, 1600 is the square of 40. So this number is greater than 40. And 2500 is the square of 50. So this number is lesser than 50. So this number lies in the range of 40 to 50. Now we know the range, and there can only be two numbers, 43 or 47. So we will check for both of them, and we find that this is the square of 43. So under root 1849 is 43. So under root x percent of under root 1849 into 20 plus 22.7 is 2602.7. Here under root x percent of 43 under root 1849 is 43 into 20 is equals to 2602.7 minus 22.7, which is 2580. And here, as we see, this is under root x percent of this number. So to find the number, we multiply this by 43 into 20 and divide it by 100, as we do it in the case of finding the percentage of any number. Like if we say that 20% of 10, then how do we find it? 10 into 20 upon 100. So here we know 2 is the 20% of 10. So we're doing the same thing for this. It's equals to 2580. On further solving, we get under root x is equals to 2580. Under root x is equals to 30, which implies x is equals to 900. X, which is question mark in the question, is 900. So the answer is D, 900. Question 4. Two baskets together have 640 oranges. If 1/5 of the oranges in the first basket to be taken to the second basket, then the oranges become equal in both the baskets. What was the number of oranges in the first basket initially? So this is the first basket, this is the second basket. Let us assume that the number of oranges in the first basket be k initially. Then in the second basket, it would be 640 minus k. So now, as per the question, k by 5 plus 640 minus k. This k by 5 is the number of oranges that are taken out from the basket 1 and then added to the basket 2. And this was the initial number of oranges present in the basket 2. So now this is the final number of oranges present in the basket 2. And now after taking out the 1/5 part, 4 by 5th of the initial number of oranges in the basket 1 remains. So further solving this equation, 640 minus k is equals to 3/5k. 8/5k is 640. Here we get k is equals to 640 into 5/8, which is 400. Initially, the number of oranges present in the basket 1 was 400. Simplify the given question and then find the value of question mark. Okay. This question looks like it is having a lot of maths to do, but don't worry. Don't get scared. If you see this, 80 into 0.4 is equals to 32. Similarly, 40 into 1.6 can be written as 64. Now we will rewrite the equation. 32 cube divided by 64 cube multiplied by 128 cube is equals to 2 to the power question mark plus 7. So here we will just expand the equation. Now you can see that 32 is a multiple of 64. 64, 64 and 64. So we see in the equation 64 cube is equals to 2 to the power question mark plus 7. On seeing the factors of 64, we see that 64 is equals to 64 could be written as 2 to the power 6. So I can write it as 2 to the power 6 to the power 3. And as we have seen it earlier, if something is written as a to the power x to the power y, then we can write it as a to the power xy. We can multiply both the powers. So here we can write this expression as 2 to the power 18 is equals to 2 to the power question mark plus 7. I'm solving it here. We can see that 18 is equals to question mark plus 7. So the question mark is 11. So your answer is B, 11. Hope you understood the concept of simplification and found the video beneficial for your preparation. And if you have any queries regarding any of the questions, do let me know in the comment section below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.